Our fourth new national park of our trip was Redwood National Estate Parks. Our first stop on our way to the park from San Francisco was Chandelier Tree, which is a redwood tree that you can drive through. Further up the coast, we also stopped to explore the first beach we came across. Towards the end of the beach, we found an area with a ton of crab shells. Our first real hike in the Redwoods was Lady Bird Johnson Grove Trail. This is a short, easy lollipop loop trail that's a great introduction to the Redwoods. We had a great time exploring these giant trees and began to get used to the foggy, rainy weather we had basically the whole time we were here. The trees weren't the only plants here that were larger than normal. It's really hard to accurately capture the scale of these trees. Redwood trees just feel like a big playground to me. On our way to our hotel, we were fortunate enough to see some Roosevelt elk in a field. The next morning, we headed back to the park as we had a permit for Fern Canyon Trail that morning. Shortly into our hike, we found a couple of banana slugs, which is common for the region. Banana slugs will eat plants that compete with young redwoods, but they generally leave the redwoods alone. Fern Canyon was a beautiful place to visit. I don't think I've ever been on a trail like it before. It's really unique to see what is essentially a wall of ferns. Fern Canyon was even used to film a few movies, most notably Jurassic Park 2. If you plan on doing this hike, I recommend hiking sandals or sneakers that drain really well, as you're likely to get your feet wet. When you reach the end, you have the option to turn around and head back the way you came, or take a trail up out of the canyon and run parallel to it. We chose to do the latter. We still had some time before our permit ran up, so we decided to check out Gold Bluffs Beach as well. This was the first time I've seen like actual polished stones at a beach. On our way back through the park, we found more Roosevelt elk hanging out in people's front yards. Our next hike was Prairie Creek Trail and Foothill Trail Loop, and I chose to do this hike solely for the opportunity to walk through trees.
It's clear.
Where's this trail lead to?
A tree you can walk through and the big tree.
Oh, so both?
Thank you.
As much as I love giant trees, I also love the ocean. So after our hike, we headed to Harris Beach, which happened to be very close to our hotel. I was amazed at how polished the rocks at this beach were as well. This trip was the first opportunity I've had to go tide pooling, and it may just be my new favorite thing. I have a whole video on our tide pooling adventures from our trip, and I'll link to it and the other videos from this trip down below. We still had some daylight remaining, so we decided to make a few more stops up the coast.
Mm-hmm. He doesn't care.
Our last stop for this portion of our trip was the well-known Natural Bridges. This area is absolutely stunning. Some of the areas of the trail down felt a bit sketchy, but the views were amazing. I got a bit mesmerized here by how the water flows back and forth over this section of rock. Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget to be always adventuring.